त्वस्मिन् परम प्रेम रूपा अमृत स्वरूपा च ओपनिंग ऑफ नारद भक्ति सूत्र वै नारद दैट इज परम प्रेम रूपा परम प्रेम नॉट जस्ट प्रेम परम प्रेम रूपा लव विच इज बियॉन्ड अमृत स्वरूप व्हाट काइंड ऑफ बियॉन्ड अमृत स्वरूप दैट विच टेक्स यू टू द हाइएस्ट स्टेट अमृत यम लब्ध्वा हैविंग फाउंड दैट व्हाट हैपेंस टू द पर्सन पुमान सिद्धो भवति तृप्तो भवति अमृतो भवति बिकम सिद्ध तृप्त अमृत Siddha means yes, he has achieved everything. There is nothing more to be achieved after that. Trupta, completely satisfied because there is nothing more to achieve. There are no more desires left. There are nothing to be gained, attained. Amruto bhavati becomes immortal. All this description of bhakti. This is not Vedanta. Mark my words. You may confuse this with Vedanta. Amruta. Maybe that is Vedantins who are supposed to be immortal. Bhakti, you know, not immortality is not there for them, is it? Amruto bhavati. But bhakti takes you to amrutatva. Yad prapya, having found that, what happens? Na kinchit vanchati. Doesn't desire for anything, that person. Desireless he becomes. Akamahata. Desireless. What else? न द्वेष्टि न शोचति न रमते नोत्साही भवति इत्सेस न द्वेष्टि डज नॉट हेट एनी वन हाउ कैन यू नॉट हेट एनी वन वेदांत आंसर्स हु डज नॉट हेट एनी वन ततो न विजुगुप्सते टुडे ईशावास्य उपनिषद टोल्ड अस हु यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भूतानि आत्मन्येव अनुपश्यति एवरीथिंग दैट इज देयर अराउंड मी इट इज ओनली आत्मन सर्वभूतेषु चात्मानं इन ऑल आई एम ओनली देयर ततो न विजुगुप्सते ओनली दैट पर्सन कैन नॉट हिट एनीबडी न द्वेष्टि न कांक्षति बृहदारण्यकोपनिषद से अयम अस्मी इति द वन्स व्हेन आई फाइंड दैट इट इज मी हियर इट इज आई एम दैट व्हाट हैपेंस किमिच्छन् कस्य कामाय शरीरम अनुसंचरेत फॉर व्हाट डिजायर फॉर व्हाट पर्पस शुड ही पुट हिज बॉडी टू ट्रबल न कांक्षति न शोचति वाई बिकॉज हिज फियर्स इज गॉन हिज सॉरोज आर गॉन न द्वेष्टि न रमति ही डजंट एंजॉय ऑल दीज काइंड्स ऑफ वर्ल्डली थिंग्स एनी मोर ही एंजॉयज ओनली दैट सुप्रीम सेल्फ नो उत्साही भवति ही बिकम्स ही लूजेज एंथुजियाज्म फॉर दीज वर्ल्डली थिंग्स बाय नेचर यद ज्ञात्वा Puman, what happens if he comes to learn about it, it realizes it? Stabdo bhavati, becomes stunned, becomes astonished, becomes overwhelmed. There's nothing more. He's in a state of a feeling of overwhelming, feeling of supreme self. There's nothing more. Tejasa abhibhuta, in the front of the shining self, illumination of the self, he becomes absolutely stupefied. Stabdo bhavati. What else? The highest he becomes there. Atma ramo bhavati. He becomes one with the divinity. This is not Advaitic Vedanta. Atma ramo, is it not Advaita? Then what is it doing in Bhakti Sutras? Amruta, is it not Vedanta? What is it doing in Bhakti Sutras? It means what? End of bhakti, the consummation, bhakti parakashta, ultimate end of bhakti is atma ramo bhavati. So therefore, bhakti, even if it's a saguna bhakti, it must lead to nirguna only. At the end of it, atma ramo bhavati has to happen. If that has not happened, then you are wandering in lanes and by lanes of this bhakti. All kinds of bhaktis are dasyam, sakhyam, atmanivedanam, shravanam, kirtanam, mananam. All kinds. But one bhakti, our Narada Bhakti Sutras towards the end says there are 11 types of dashaikadha, 11 types of asaktis are there, attachment to God or love for God. In that one, tanmayata asakti is there. गुणमहिमासक्ति, पूजा आसक्ति, रूप आसक्ति, ऑल काइंड ऑफ आसक्ति, स्मरणासक्ति, दास्यासक्ति, वात्सल्यासक्ति, कांत्यासक्ति, आत्मनिवेदनासक्ति, परम विरहासक्ति, तन्मयतासक्ति. वॉट इज तन्मयतासक्ति? देन बिकम वन तन्मय, शर्वत तन्मयो भवेत. वंस इट रीचेस ब्रह्मन, इट बिकम्स वन विद ब्रह्मन. हाउ? लाइक द एरो, व्हेन रीचेस द टारगेट, बिकम्स वन इन द टारगेट. तन्मयता शक्ति इज देयर, भक्ति इज देयर. सो हाउ कैन भक्ति बी एट कॉन्फ्लिक्ट और लॉगर हेड्स विथ अद्वैता? इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल, इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. द वन हु रियली नोज भक्ति, इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. वॉट काइंड ऑफ भक्ति वी एंडेड अप इन? All bhakti except Atmanivedanam. The moment it came to Atmanivedanam, no, this far, not further. The time it came for the river to become the ocean, no, I'll rather remain a river. That's what has been happening to most of the people who think they are bhaktas. Very good shravanam, beautiful, they come to attend all the discourses. Kirtanam, don't even ask. If they sing in Chikbalapura, you can hear in Muddanhalli. Vishnu Smaranam, not inside, loud chanting, and everybody should know Sai Ram, Sai Ram, Sai Ram, that I am the Sai Bhakta. Vandanam, Archanam, Padasevanam, Vandanam, Archanam, all kinds of, you know, karyakramas being arranged, prayer sessions, puja sessions, Archanam, all kinds of programs are being organized. Center program, Samiti program, national programs, international programs. Padasevanam, so to say, if not directly, at least in the photo, I am doing bhakti, Padasevanam. Dasyam, no, I am a sevadal, I am a volunteer. What does that mean? I will go and distribute food, distribute water, distribute medicines, distribute this. I'll become a volunteer serving in Swami's institutions. Dasyam. Sakhyam, a few rows a little more, being quite close to Swami in terms of their affection, in terms of their attachment, in terms of their understanding. Swami also would allow them to experience that Sakhya Bhakti. How many Atmanivedanam cases are there? Count on your fingertips. Till Sakhyam they came, how many went into Atmanivedana? Means they stopped existing after that. Atma Ramo Bhavati. Then there were no two then. There was only one. How many? How many? How many? It means bhakti has not matured itself into Advaita Darshanam. It has not become Tanmayata. It has not become Atmanivedanam. And that's where my problem is. I have come to give you what you ask for, so that one day you will ask for what I have come to give. I give whatever you ask. Give me this, give me that, give me this. All right, okay. One day I hope you will be done with all the asking and finally you have nothing to ask. Then I can give you what I have come to give. It was never different. It was always the undertone of all the things were Advaita only. But different people, Munde, Matir Bhinna, they understood things in a different way. What they were interested in, they took that part of the message and went. Some people picked up meditation, some people picked up seva, some people picked up some Vedanta from also that. Some people picked up only pure bhakti. Some people did not understand, just looking at Swami is all that they wanted, nothing more there was in their minds. So everybody took their own things from this Kalpavriksha. All as per their desires and wants. Job, wife, children, money. And after money, more money. Then after everything is done, retirement, seva opportunity. All kinds of things. How many really asked and said that I just want to realize myself? Very few. That's why it is said. It is not possible for everyone to understand this. That's why old time they have said, Vedantam Paramaguhyam. It's a very, very secret thing. In those days, in Purakalpe, in the old times alone, not in the modern times, nobody should be teaching this. In old times, it was Prachodati. It was all taught in the old times, not in the new times. Why? Na prashanta mansa manasa datavyam. Don't give this to people who don't have a pleasant mind. If you have so many desires, how can your mind be pleasant, peaceful? Na datavyam, don't give them. It says na aputram, aputrasya na ashishyasya. Don't even give to the one who is not your son or not your shishya, because they will not understand unless you have, they have lived with you, they have grown with you, they have understood, they have become prashanta manasa. Even if you teach it, and nothing will go inside their head. So when so many people are arthi artha arthi jignasyus, head filled with too many things, where was the place for them to learn about the atmagyana? Busy with day to day worries and family issues and professional issues and legal issues and every issue, where was the time, when was their head empty to think about these higher things? When were they empty? No, prashanta mans, don't give to those who don't have any. Aprashanta manasya, prashanti nilayam you'll reach, but man is aprashanta only. Why? Because you've come to prashanta primarily to gain something, get something, have your prayers answered. Even if you come as a volunteer with too many conditions, type of accommodation, type of job, where I should be posted, where I should not be posted, who should, all kinds of desires. Who has come empty, totally empty to God? Now, there's a story of this Zen master. Somebody goes to him and says, I want to learn from you. One full year, like our Prashna Upanishad Sishyas, tapasa brahmacharyena shraddhaya samvatsara, one full year you spend on that, then only come and ask me. Like our Prajapati of Brihadaranyaka, Indra and Virochana, keep coming back, another 35 years, another 35 years, another 35 years. So it was not taught to everyone. People came, but for their own things. They did not come to get, that is why he always says the kalpavriksha, you go to kalpavriksha and ask for a coffee podi, because that's all your mind is thinking of at this point in time. Verbally they will say, Swami, grant me moksha, but the moment Swami says, come, I'll grant you moksha, no, not today, I have things to do, my son has to get married, my daughter has to be settled, and I'm expecting a grandchild right now, and house is half built, and that legal issue with my brother or my father's property is going on. So moksha, I want moksha only from you, but right now I don't want. Come, I'll come later. That later never comes. That never comes. He always has have a reason why this is not time for that Advaita Darshanam. This is not time for moksha. See, again, so beautiful. Shvetashvatara Upanishad says, who gets it? Ati ashrama, not ashrama dharma followers. Ati ashramis. What is ati ashramis? Those who have gone beyond ashram dharmas, forget I am grahastha, brahmacharya, vanaprastha. I just want that self-realization. They are called ati ashramis. Others are not allowed to go. Rishi Sangha Jushtam, those who are desiring Jushtam, those who are only wanting that, to them, when the Rishi speaks, they understand. Otherwise, they don't understand. Prakashante Mahatmanaha, only in the mind of the pure, it shines, not in the mind of other people. Why? Because they have left the ati ashramis they have become. So I was thinking we should change our ashram's name to ati ashrama, so that you only think of Brahman and nothing else. Otherwise everybody is taking refuge in those cracks and corners of grihastha, brahmacharya, vanaprastha. No, not yet. I was telling the story of this Brahman who keeps doing, you know, all kinds of karmakandas, yagnikandas, all these things, and wants to pray for Brahmagyana. And when the guru comes and says, come, I'll take you and teach you Brahmagyana, I will give you moksha. He says, not now, my son is small, when he grows up, when he comes back again, no, he's getting married, after the marriage you come. When he comes after the marriage, they are expecting a grandchild, so come after that. Grandchild is too small, my son is too careless, I have to protect the wealth, so come again. Finally, what happens? This old man passes away, but yet he has not got moksha. And he's born as a snake to protect the wealth of the family, which is buried in the backyard. And finally beaten to death by his own grandchildren. How many are serious about it? I want it right now. here and now. And God says, okay, come here, give up everything, forget your jobs, forget your wives, forget your homes, forget your wealth, forget your degrees, forget your parents, forget everything else, because anyway this has to be going away from you today or tomorrow. Come, I'll give you moksha. How many will get up and say, let's go? Let's go. You are done with your wife, children, parent, family. Vasudevananda is telling, I am coming. That is because you are done with everything. Somebody in the midst of all the youth and vigor and so many ambitions and ideas and desires, how many will get up and say, I am here ready. Come Swami, take me. I want to attain moksha. How many people have dropped everything and ran behind God, tell me? How many have done that in the past? Every bhakti comes with a condition, terms and conditions. I'll be a bhakta provided 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, the list goes on and things keep adding with every passing year. So this will happen, then I'm bhakti. When will this bhakti mature? When it will culminate into Atma Ramo Bhavati? When it will culminate into Amruto Bhavati, Tripto Bhavati, Sabdo Bhavati? When will it culminate into? That is the question I'm asking. Then what is the use of such a bhakti which does not make you one with your Bhagavan? Isn't it? It is not. That is why I was yesterday also emphasized it in so many different ways. That see, even if you have bhakti, it will only help you. You should, the reason for having bhakti is to reach the realization. And once you realize your bhakti for whichever God you have will become reinforced, will become even stronger, because you realize my God is only Brahman. It will become even more powerful. Otherwise, you are stuck with where did he go, which path he took, whom did he speak to, whom he called for interview, what he gave them, who is the new VIP in the corridor, why the old one has been kicked out, who is the student always hovering around Swami, who is the fellow who has been thrown away, what is happening in the canteen, who is the new boss over there. This is what mind was busy with. Then where is the question of having this emptiness of the mind, Vishuddhatma, to attain this higher knowledge? There is no place. That is what the Zen master was saying. After 1 year, he kept this disciple. And the disciple was doing, seeing what this master is doing. He is cleaning the floor, cleaning this, going and doing, drawing water, whatever, cutting wood, as he said. He was busy. After 1 year, this fellow lost his patience, saying that this cannot be a jnani. Look at the same thing he does every day. And he hasn't spoken one word to me in 1 year. What kind of fellow he is? And then he went to this. Finally, he lost his patience and he could see his restlessness. And then this fellow asked, what happened? He said, I don't know. 1 year I have been here, but I haven't learned anything from you. Now, I don't even think you are capable of teaching anything, because I see you doing just the ordinary mundane tasks. Doesn't look like you are a Brahma Jnani. That's what people thought of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa too. Doesn't look like. Look at his behavior. Madman. Then the Zen master called him and said, let's have a cup of tea. And he put two cups and started pouring tea. And as he kept on pouring, the tea started overflowing in the cup. And the other fellow said that, so what are you doing? It's overflowing. There's no more place. He said, that's exactly your mind is like right now. It's overflowing with so many other things. There is no place for my Brahma Jnana in your mind. It's too full of yourself, too full of desires, too full of wants, attachments. There's no place for me to teach you any further. First you empty yourself and come. Then there is something possible. But we are so scared. Why? How can we empty ourselves? What will happen to me, my family, job, future? He will take care. In one side we say, Swami is only going to look after everything. Other side we are so particular that we are on top of things. Now how is it bhakti, you tell me? Bhakti reva gariyasi. Correct, bhakti is the highest. But the highest should lead you to the highest thing. That should lead you to that Atmanivedanam. But how many? How many are living in that state? Even as bhaktas. I'm not even telling they're following Vedanta. Even as bhaktas, they're completely satisfied. There are no more desires left. Tripto, Siddho, Amruto. Everything they are. They don't hate anyone. They don't know na kaankshati, na shochati, na dveshti, na ramate, na utsahi bhavati. How many? Small things excite them, small things make them hate, small things make them get angry, small things make them desire for more. So where is that bhakti? How can we call ourselves bhakta? Because bhakti means atmaramo. It should become one with your divine self. Then there is advaita only. Where is dvaita there? If your mind has been merged, amani bhava, na dvaitam upalabhyate. Your manas has become amani. No mind is, because your mind is merged with Swami. Even then, this is advaita only. That is atmanivedana. But we, as you say, we are happy with whatever 146th floor, 48th floor. Good enough, this view is good enough for me. No, no, there is some possibility going on. No, 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 this is good enough for me. And I can see the whole of Dubai. I can even see Abu Dhabi and Sharjah and beyond. I think I see American the tower also. I do not interested in going further up. I'm sort happy. Then who can take you up? Udharedatman atmanam. You only have to lift yourself up. God cannot lift yourself up. That is why it is said. It is just not possible with this kind of bhakti. What kind of bhakti? The bhakti which always is seeking, seeking, seeking. And as long as it's getting, there is God. The moment it's not getting, there is no God. That bhakti is not going to take anywhere. Radha bhakti, Vrajagopikanam, Narada said. What kind of bhakti? Vrajagopikanam. And what kind of people are there? Tad vismarane paramavyakulate. They become so restless. I have not seen him, attained him, realized him. That bhakti is also okay. Tadarpita, akhila charana. Everything that they do is for that God's sake only. Nothing for my sake. There is not an iota of selfishness and self-interest in that person. And if he forgets this very thought that I am not one with my divine self, my Lord, paramavyakulate, they become restless like fish out of water. Till it goes back into water. But our fishes are how? As long as they get into Premdeep Hall, they are in water. Hey, satsang is going on. I am not invited. Half the world has been invited. Why this treatment to me? That is vyakulate. No, that is not vyakulate. So many getting interview. Why am I not getting interview? Vyakulate. That is not paramavyakulate. Paramavyakulate is that how can I live without my Lord? He's inside me right here. When Meera searched for him everywhere, finally went and all the way back, walked up to Mathura. And you know, she went and to the mandir and then the doors were closed saying that it was time for puja, time is over, you come tomorrow. She said, I can't wait one more day to see Krishna. I have to see now. She said, not possible. And she became so disappointed and cried to Krishna. And as she was crying, she hit her head on the door of the mandir. And immediately she had the vision of Krishna as one with herself. And she became a realized bhakta. But Meera had any other desires, you tell me. She had any other desires, she had any other ideas, ambitions. Paramavyakulte, only one restlessness is to, I have to merge with my Lord, divine. Otherwise they had no, I'm a chairman, I'm a principal, warden, am I being given enough and more here, am I having respected, am I having position, any authority, any power, people recognize for my service, do I get enough of, you know, chances with Swami, do I even get to be called for satsang or not called for satsang, am I recognized as the oldest possible devotee of this Baba, where is bhakti, bhukti, bhukti, bhukti it is. And they want to claim themselves to be the closest and dearest, not possible. Atmanivedanam alone is the highest bhakti. Atmanivedanam means you are not there, only one is there. That's why I was telling, Kabir says, Premagali Badi Sakari, it is a very narrow lane. Do na samahi, two cannot fit in that lane. Jab mai tha, sai nahi, ab sai hai, mai nahi. When I was there was no place for sai in this. Now sai has entered, I have no place for myself. Means when, where did the anger come from next time? When you claim to be like that, always merged in Tanmayata, where did the anger come when the next person did not respect you? Where did hatred come when the other person was not doing exactly as you said? Where the desires came from that I am not being invited, not being promoted, not being recognized, acknowledged, appreciated? Where did it all come from? Because you are also there in the lane, therefore God is not there in that lane. You think God is there, He's not there. Why? Because he didn't give enough place. It's very narrow. Only one can fit. I always say, it's not a musical chair. It's a single sofa. Musical chair means any people today this, tomorrow another. But single sofa it is. Nobody else can sit other than God. How many have really lived? If they really lived, they will be tripto, siddho, amruto, na kankshati, na shochati, na hrishati, na dveshti. Tripto, stabdho, atma ramo, amruto. Everything should be the quality of that devotee who has really been a devotee. All others are bhuktas only, in the garb of bhakti, bhaktas. Inside is bhukti only. Swami, please give me this, please do this for me, please help me with that, please take care of this. I only depend on you. But what is that you're depending for? Somebody sent me a message. Swami, I feel that I'm going to die very soon. But I have so many responsibilities. And you know, you have to look out, you have to help me. The other way should have been, Swami, I believe I'm going to die very soon. But then doesn't matter because anyway, you only are looking after everything. Am I looking after anything? You are only looking after everything. So you only should look after that also. Whether I am here or not, it is incidental. My absence also you look after. My presence also you only are looking after. In fact, I may be interfering with your looking after. You could do it better in my absence perhaps. That bhakti, how many have that bhakti? Therefore, I am not satisfied with people just claiming bhakti by putting vibhuti, wearing whites, knowing some suprabhatam and Ashtottar Namavali and serving in the institutions and singing bhajans. I am not satisfied. Those times are over. Either you, even in that field, in that lane also, at least become, reach that stage of Atma Ramo, Atma Nivedanam. I am okay. Because that is the same thing. Another name. Another way of calling it. It is the same thing. Otherwise, take to this path of Atma Vichara that I have been telling. Because through bhakti we have not reached that far. Somehow this Nama Rupa thing, we got caught somewhere on the way. It's so powerful, this Nama Rupa confusion, you can imagine. Those devotees of Rama cannot be devotees of Krishna. Shiva devotees have fought wars with Vishnu's devotees. Think of all the confusion that this Nama Rupa has created in the past. If you had attained that highest of the bhakti, parabhakti, yasya deve parabhakti, the one who has parabhakti in that God, which deva? Your own self, the divine self. That is what he said. The true bhakti is what? Bhakti to the divine who resides within. Swaswarupa. Become one with that. That is the definition of bhakti. Who gave? Shankaracharya. But I am going back to Narada Bhakti Sutra. Is there any better bhakta than Narada? But Narada is confirmed, validated, endorsed, authenticated bhakta, isn't it? In his Bhakti Sutra is Yam Labdhva Puman Siddho Bhavati, Tripto Bhavati, Amruto Bhavati, Yad Prapya, Na Kinchita, Vanchati, Na Shochati, Na Dveshti, Na Ramate, Na Utsahi Bhavati. Yam Gyatva, Sidhe Atma Ramo Bhavati, says, you become one with that, there is no in between. So where is the confusion between bhakti and advaita? I mean, Narada himself is telling all these things. In all types of bhakti, he also talks about tanmayata bhakti. In all types of bhakti, Bhagavatam talks about atmanivedanam. But how many reach that atmanivedanam? If you reach atmanivedanam, you become one with divinity, then you will realize this only is jnana, this is only advaita. This is no difference of bhakti here. The same thing it is. So there is no confusion, no conflict anywhere. But those who don't understand, they are limited-minded people, aprashanta manasa, not a deserving person. Such a person will always look at this as different from that and, you know, keep on talking. But all that bhakti has not led you to jnana, therefore I am not happy, therefore I am not satisfied with that. If you had become a jnani by end of that bhakti, you should have no dveshti, na shochati, na kankshati, na ramati, na utsahi, tripto, amruto, siddho, stabdho, atma ramo. Everything you have become, that should have happened by now. 50 years if you have stayed with Swami, it should have definitely happened. 50 years you did the same thing. Anybody who does the same thing for 50 years should become the world's topmost expert in that, isn't it? Topmost expert. 50 years you have been doing the same thing, you should be the expert. So how is it that you practice bhakti for 50 years and you are not still the expert bhakta in terms of? Now, sometimes I listen to speeches and other things of people talking about Swami's life and I just feel so empty, it's so empty. So empty, it's so sketchy. There's no stuff inside. Just talking, repeating like parrots. Without really having that conviction. it doesn't appeal to me. That's why I said, in that way you describe Swami as Karunamaya, Premamaya, Sevasakta, all these things are fine. Brahma Rupa and all, you don't deserve to speak. Because you don't understand what it is. You're just repeating like a parrot. That doesn't appeal to me. Other things, what you have experienced, you speak to that extent. Swami helped me with my schooling, education, took care of me and looked after me. Oh, he's like a mother to me. He's like, okay, mother, father, whatever, Uru, Bandha, Saka, all that is all settled there. Straight away, don't jump and say, he's a Parabrahma Swarupa, he's a Purna Avatara. What do you know? What do you understand of it? So he keeps telling the story. Somebody went from Tunisia Datta Maharaj and said, who is Satya Sai Baba? He said, who is Shirdi Sai Baba? Was the previous avatar? Satya Sai Baba is the second avatar. So who was, what was in between Shirdi Sai and Satya Sai? That is what he is. Oh, such a wonderful, 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 wonderful only he is. No wonderful. Parabrahma Rupa. Oh, wonderful. What does it mean? A Parabrahma Rupa. So what does it mean? What do you understand of it? No, he is the highest, above all gods. Deva Atitaya, Guna Atitaya, Sarva Devata Atitaya. So what? What does it mean to you? No, no, I am worshipping the best of the gods. You know, I am the higher category. My church is of superior standing in the society. Bhakti is not to do with anything external. How many bhajans you sing, how many times you chant the name, how many times you have visited the ashram, how many sevadal activities you have participated in. At the end of it, what matters, have you realized that you are one with the same divinity? It is not two, it is one. Have you realized? No, then you are not done. Your bhakti has not found fulfillment. You are somewhere in the lower floor somewhere. We are happy with that view, that's a different story. But the true bhakta will always be advaitic. His understanding of his divine Lord will be always that of Brahman, and his association of, with the divine Lord will be the same. I and you are one. Now Jesus said, I am the messenger of God, then I am the son of God, then I and my father are one. Isn't he said that? So I and my father are one. Oh, this is like blasphemy, should somebody say? Church didn't say it's a blasphemy when he said I and my father are one. But as bhakti, strict bhakti technical guidelines, rule book, it will say, how can you say that you are the same as Krishna, you are the same as Rama? No, no, Rama Krishna is God, you are this. One person came to see Swami, you know, one of the old acquaintance, and he got so angry. Why your Baba is sitting on the stage along with Krishna in Vrindavan? I told, because he is Krishna. What are you talking? How can he be Krishna? Krishna is Krishna Bhagavan. And first of all, don't keep calling Krishna. Shri Krishna Ji. We keep calling Krishna Rama. You got so wild. Don't call Krishna Krishna. Shri Krishna Ji. Shri Krishna Ji hai. To Baba udhar kyun baitha hai? Wo stage Krishna ke liye, Shri Krishna Ji ke liye hai ki Baba ke liye hai? Both are same. How can you say both are same? Such a blasphemy this is. I know they both are same. Got angry, left the ashram. That bhakti. Shirdi Baba bhakti. No, this, how could this Satya Sai Baba's photo be next to the Shirdi Baba photo? You know who is he? Like that, we have had enough of issues with bhakti. Has created more and more confusion in the world. Only Advaita has resolved all confusion. All religions, everybody has bhakta only. All have fought tooth and nail. The number of people killed in the world because of religion is more than being killed by any other reason. All are bhaktas only. What have they achieved? Did they have Advaita Darshanam? Did they understand everything is one? No. So still there are differences, disputes. What bhakti is that? Na dveshti, na shochati, na kangshati. Where is all that quality? Bhakti, 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 bhakti. What bhakti is that? That is why I am pushing everybody to realize, because when you realize that Atman, your bhakti will only become pure, it will become mature, it will become true. It will not be this pseudo-bhakti. You will really understand what bhakti means only when you have realization of oneness with your Bhagavan. That is when you will truly know what bhakti means and what Bhagavan is. Till then, it's only imagination. Therefore, this imagination is not leading us anywhere. Andhe naiva niyamana yathandaha. blind leading the blind. Of course, it has helped. How it has helped? It has helped Chittasya Shuddhaye. It has helped us become purer, less selfish. Has helped us reduce our desires, unwanted desires. Has helped us become better behave, better people in the society. Conduct ourselves more morally, more spiritually, socially. We are more helpful to people. Yes, it has given so many benefits, but still it is at the 148th floor. So could we have gone till 148th floor without bhakti? No. Bhakti has helped us go this far, but can it help us further? No. Beyond that, jnana alone can help us. Beyond that, bhakti cannot help us. So that understanding of the divinity, that it is one with everything, including you, me, and everybody. And when did Swaminath say, "I am God, so are you. I know, you don't." When did was it not "Aham Brahma, Tvam Brahma, Sarvam Brahma"? When was it not? Every time it was. I know, you don't know. That's always the difference. But how many people took this statement so seriously and started working on that? No, I must also know that I am God. Somebody asks question, who are you? The answer comes, I am the state president, state vice president, I am the convener, I am the center in charge, I am this and that. Who are you? I am divine, one with my master. How many could say that? That bhakti, not gariyasi. That is not the greatest. So that's why I said, let us go by the definition of our Shankaracharya, who was also great bhakta. Half of this sutotram that we chant here are all Shankaracharya's kritis. While he wrote the highest treatise on Advaita, he also wrote so many suktas and so many of this, even this Dakshinamurti stotram, everything is by Shankaracharya, Kanna Kanakadhara stotram, so many of them. So how did he reconcile with bhakti and Advaita together? Because he didn't see these two as different. He saw one complementing the other. More bhakti, more Advaita darshan. More Advaita darshan, more bhakti. It was helping each other. It was not different like two legs. Both helped him walk. So, bhakti, moksha, karana, samagraya, all the items that are required to attain moksha, bhakti reva gariyasi, it's all there in bhakti. But what is bhakti? Let us understand that. Sa swarupa sandhanam, to realize, to know oneself. Bhakti riva itti abhidhiyate, I believe, I understand, I opine that that is what is bhakti. What? Sa swarupa sandhanam, you realize your own true self. That is true bhakti. So then Shvetashvatara Upanishad ends, closes, it says, have devotion to that divine. And the devotion that you have for the divine, the same devotion you show to your guru also. Yatha deve tatha guru. Same bhakti. Or what kind of bhakti? Parabhakti. Yasya deve parabhakti. Highest devotion you show. Means it doesn't have any desires, wants, positions, authorities, powers. Nothing is there in that. It's pure, unblemished. There's nothing in that. That bhakti you show to the divine, same bhakti you show to your guru is taking you towards the divine. Why? Because he has attained this how? Tapaprabhavat, daiva prasadat. By tapas and by God's grace, Shvetashvatara Muni has attained Brahman. And so he is teaching whom? Ati ashramin. Not ordinary people. Ati ashramin. And who are ati ashramins? Whose only goal in life is to realize Brahman. They are the residents of Ati Ashramin, Ati Ashrama. So if you say Satya Sai Gama Ashrama, Satya Sai Grama, Ati Ashrama you should call it now. Only realization of self is the goal of the Ashramin, which other things are secondary and not even important. Main goal is to realize the Ati Ashramin, he said. Paramam Pavitram is most sacred knowledge this Muni is teaching. To whom? Provacha, he teaching to whom? Rishi Sangha Jushtam. To the group of rishis who are so eager to learn this knowledge. Because they're Ati Ashram, means they don't have any other agenda in life. They have nothing more to think of. Their bhakti has culminated into this kind of Vyakulate. To realize their true self, their oneness with their divine master. And Nama Rupa have fallen away on the way. Priyam Bhati Asti, they are slowly rising to the highest floor. This is why Advaita Vedanta is not different, not contradictory, not conflicting. But it is complementing the very fact that bhakti is that. Otherwise, bhakti by itself should be able to lead you there. But unfortunately, we have not understood what true bhakti is. So I am redefining it. Satswarup Sandhanam is only bhakti. There is no other bhakti for me. Not even going to Sarnam, Smash, whatever, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smarnam, gone past all. That is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. No, they are not more important. Now, Satswarup Sandhanam, you should realize who you are. That is bhakti. And because only when you do that, then Narada's definition of bhakti is fulfilled. Atma Ramo Bhavati. He realizes that he is the Atma Rama. So Narada also will be happy that his definition has finally found fulfillment. Why? Because we have done Sasvarupa Sandhanam. We have found out who we are. And so next time I ask you who you are, I am divine. Means in your heart that conviction should be there. Of course, for all practical purposes, you will have to explain as it is. But deep down, that the conviction is there inside. That yes, this is all the outside drama I have to perform. But because you have no hatred for anybody, no desires, nothing, there is nothing more left inside you. You don't exist actually. He alone exists. Or that alone exists, whichever way you call it. You don't exist. Where is the question of all these other thoughts coming and going? Sam shanta sang sarva sankalpa. Completely peaceful, no desires, no thought of their own. As and when people are coming, you're interacting and finishing your work and going back to the same sasvarupa sthiti, sasvarupa sandhanam. That is true bhakti. So even if you're a bhakta, your target is far, far ahead of you. You're not yet reached there. By number of years associated and by number of times you have visited, by number of hours spent in doing bhajana and kirtana and seva, by being head of this and that and having positions and authorities, none of these qualify you to be a bhakta. Because this may be bhakta, but parabhakti it is not. And only parabhakti can lead paramaprema rupaya, amrutaswarupaya. Paramaprema rupa it is, amrutaswarupa. Only then you get all this. Siddho bhavati, tripto bhavati, atma ramo bhavati, and all that bhavatis which should come with that bhakti. Otherwise it's not bhakti. And when you are not reaching that kind of a feeling, I'm still having desires, I'm still having anger, I'm still having these wants, I am still not restful, I am restless. I still get engaged and I am interested in these worldly things. I still get excited by new things. Then you know that you are not having that. Then what should happen? Oh, I am forgetting who I am. Tad vismarane paramavyakulte. You should become restless. That tivrata of your intensity of your search, intensity of your desire or whatever want or wish to realize yourself should become even stronger. Paramavyakulate should come. See what beautiful. Vyakulate, it is a paramavyakulate. Prema rupa, parama prema rupa. Bhakti, para bhakti, he said. So unless we develop that kind of bhakti, that also will redeem us. That's also fine. But let us not fool ourselves. I tell the story of this king who was never going to the temple, never mentioning the name of Rama. His wife was always going to the temple, you know, morning 7 o'clock. She is in the temple. What happens to the breakfast of the king, that we will see later. First my god should eat. First I should finish my puja. So all thought queen is a great devotee. And this queen will go and cry to the god, my husband is not at all your devotee. Doesn't chant your name, doesn't think of you. What a sad thing it is. Please bless him with some bhakti. And one night in the dream, suddenly, Rama, Rama, he said. And she got up and heard Rama, Rama. Oh, my husband is chanting Rama's name. So next morning she woke up, she woke her husband up and said, I'm so happy today. What happened? You were chanting the name of Rama in the dream. Oh, what a mistake I made. I never wanted anybody to know that I am a devotee. It's unnecessary bring ego. I just wanted to be quietly worshipping my Lord. But now you found out my secret. So he lamented. So that is another bhakti. And there are others. Every possible sign of being recognized as bhakta, they'll put on themselves. From scarf, to badges, to a big vibhuti, to the spotless whites. You can make out from distance, oh, this is his coming, he's, you know, he'll announce his presence here now. Push everybody, go and sit in the front. I've seen all this, it's not new. How long is the question? Enough, that is over. This university, he said it right. We are rising now, rise with these times. He's going to the university. Shirdi Baba Bhaktas could not recognize Satya Sai Baba and they fought. So Satya Sai Baba's Bhakta, they will not recognize, they will also get into confusion, let them. Because only that person, Sarva Samshaya, Chindyanti, all doubts will be dispelled for whom? Tasmin Drishte Paravare, he sees that Paravare, beyond, the one that is beyond the one who sees, that person alone will know all are same. In fact, you, me, this table, chair, everything is same, they will know. We are all floating in a sea of consciousness. We are consciousness. We are that Brahman. And that realization will destroy all doubts. That is what is required. All doubts will be dispelled. Chidyante sarva samshaya. All doubts. Why this is like that? Why this change in the teaching now? What is this new thing happening? Has Swami left this and some other ghost has appeared over here? What is going on over here? Same thing it is. Why? Because their tasmin drishte paravare is not happened. They have not seen what that is beyond. So such bhakti is dangerous. Jamvan fought and fought with Krishna. Vehemently, really wanted to kill Krishna. That's a different story that he could not kill. Suppose he was even powerful. He would have hurt Krishna, but definitely in that fight with his claws and all, would he not have hurted Krishna? Some hurt would have come to Krishna, some injury. You fight for so many days, 18 days, and you don't get an injury. That too with a ferocious wild bear who is expert in fighting. That too is fighting to save his only daughter. So imagine how ferociously Jamavanta would have fought with Krishna to defeat him. In the process, how many wounds, how many injuries he would have inflicted upon Krishna's tender body. What use is that bhakti is my question, which couldn't recognize its Bhagwan, because it was stuck in the name and form, nama, rupa. What use is that bhakti? So that bhakti will not lead us anywhere. It has led us this far, that's fine. Further, it has to turn into jnana or parabhakti. Parabhakti is nothing but another name for jnana bhakti. Jnana only, advaita bhakti, as you're saying. The same thing it is. From dvaita bhakti, advaita bhakti. Have we not heard about nirguna upasana? Saguna upasana, nirguna vibhakti, 12th chapter, we heard about it. People who worship the form versus who don't worship the form. What is the difference? He said, both will reach me, but the people who worship the form is easier for them. Provided that finally they give up that form and name. Finally also they keep holding on to that and don't believe in anything else. Then they'll get into these confusions. Religious wars. So, the idea of that realization alone can redeem us from our petty thinking and narrow understanding of what is devotion, what is a devotee and who is God. All this will become clear. Vidyate hridaye gantish. All the doubts and all the knots in our hearts will be destroyed. Why? Because we have understood tasmin drishte paravar. We have seen the oneness of everything and therefore we have no problem with anything. We know the Brahman alone exists and we can see Brahman shines forth from within. The purer the mind, the higher the shine. You can see that in that person. So everything is one. That is the only solution to the problems of this world. Not only religious conflicts, but all conflicts will come to an end. That is what I was teaching. Isa vasyam idam sarvam yat kinchat jagatyam jagat tena tyaktena bhunjitha magudha kasya svidhanam. Don't steal from anybody. Live with a sense of sacrifice because everything is divine. All that you see, them sarvam. Everything is divine. So where is the question of conflicts, fights, stealing, harming, hurting, cheating? No place for it. The one who thinks everything is divine. So that is why we have to intensify our efforts. More and more and more. That we have gone this far, if not able to realize that, means we have to put some more effort. And it says very nicely, Shvetashvatara Upanishad says, तप प्रभावात् दैव प्रसादात् ब्रह्मा हू फाउंड आउट ब्रह्मा श्वेताश्वतर विद्वान ही केम टू नो अबाउट ब्रह्मन हाउ तप प्रभावात् सेम थिंग भृगु तपसो ब्रह्म विजिज्ञासस्व गो डू तपस तप न तपस मीन्स तपना द बर्निंग डिजायर आई मस्ट रियलाइज परम व्याकुलते I haven't realized even today. I have not understood this Paramatattva. What a loss, what a loss of a day. I have sang and like Ravindranath Tagore told, the song that I came to sing remains unsung to this day. I have spent all my day in stringing and unstringing the instrument. That should not become our fate at the end of it. You know, bhakti, 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 all right. At the end of it, that doesn't turn into parabhakti, doesn't take you to the Atma Rama Anubhava. It has not really helped you. Helped you to some extent, of course. But not really, you didn't realize its true potential. So that's where the issue is. So please pay more and more and more attention. Tapas, brahmacharya, shraddha. Tapas, burning desire. Must attain that. How can I miss that? How many years I've spent? Still I have not understood the truth. What is the use? That tapas, brahmacharya, all the time mind is in Brahman. All the time thinking of that. Shraddha and the faith that if I keep putting effort by tapas prabhavat and daiva prasada, it will come to me at some point in time. With continuous effort. And become ati ashrami. Become ati ashrami. Whose only agenda of the life is to know yourself. Knowing which? Everything is known. That is the only solution. Because it is the only solution, so there is no other way we can do it. There is no other way. If you tell me, don't do it this way, do it another way. I say, there is no other way. There is only one way. So we have to move on this way. Okay, all those who like this way, please follow. That's all I can say. The rest is up to you. Sit on the 148th floor and watch. That's all will happen to others. So that's why I say there are many more heights to be, you know, achieved. We have to still rise. We have not risen. Till we become one with that divine, we have not truly, truly become devotees. So now go by whichever definition, Narada's bhakti definition or Shankaracharya's bhakti definition. Both are indicating ultimately to the same state of oneness. Advaita. They are not telling things as different from each other. So try to understand that and don't develop this ignorant conflict or this idea that what is this Swami's teaching? It is not at all in line with that. The same thing, I am God, so are you. I know you don't. Everything is God. Laval Sarval, the other day was saying, Swami, from Laval Sarval looks like he's moving to Aham Brahma, Sarvam Brahma. I said, I understood Laval Sarval is not happening. Therefore, the only way, love all, not love a few, serve all, not serve conveniently a few. All will happen only when you realize all is Brahman. So there are two ways. Either do love all, serve all and reach Aham Brahma, Sarvam Brahma. If that is not happening, reach Aham Brahma, Sarvam Brahma and go back to love all, serve all. Because naturally you will be loving all, serving all. That is the nature of that jnani. Shanto, Mahanto, Nivasanti, Santo, Vasantavat, Lokahita. Charantaha. Swayam Tirna Bhima Bharna Bhima Bhava Arnavam Janan Hetu Nanya Pitarayantaha. Having himself crossed, he helps others cross the ocean of samsara. Like the Vasantaritu which comes and brightens up the whole place. That is the idea of a Santa, the realized one. So even then it is the same thing. It'll be, love all, serve all will become your very nature. What do? I do love all, serve all. It's natural for me. Why? Because I am Brahman. And everything is Brahman. So how many of us truly realize love all, serve all? Let us ask this question to ourselves. Nicely quoted, nicely printed everywhere. But how many of us really have followed love all, serve all? Have we not hated one person also? Swami's message is love all. Have we not even hated one person? If we have hated, then we have not followed Swami's message to the T. So it means our bhakti is not strong enough. If our bhakti was so strong, then we should have followed love all. So bhakti has not helped us with that. Let jnana help us now. That we are all one, therefore love all. There is no question of hating anybody. You have to do what you have to do as a part of your duty. Teachers will have to be stern, tough with the children. That is a part of their duty. But inside, there is no hatred. Because you know, no deshti, not dveshti. So how can I hate if I am a devotee? So these are all same things, you know. Like four blind men trying to understand the elephant. Let us not fool ourselves. Open our eyes and see things as they are supposed to be. That is very important. Otherwise, it will lead to another line of confusion from here onwards.